Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Outliers, the Story of Success book by Malcolm Gladwell. This book arrived dirty with even some food, or something dried on the cover, dirty fingerprints, and warped cover, and first few pages like it had gotten wet. It is grounded in a web of advantages and inheritances, some deserved, some not, some earned, some just plain lucky, but all critical to making them who they are. The writing was fantastic, and the facts were presented mostly in a fluid, easy-to-understand way. Wonderful book. Examines the combinations of intelligence, opportunities, hard work, social, and ethnic backgrounds, and environments, and occasionally sheer luck that result in outstanding success stories. It's very easy to take away from this book the understanding that Outliers Amazing People is the result of the combination of a lot of forces, with the primary forces being that of being good enough, being in the right environment, practice, dedication to growth, luck, and timing. Malcolm Gladwell also explains from many different angles why outliers are not simply the ones with amazing genetics, as it requires many forces to become an outlier, including pure luck and timing. When Stern asked Rock what it took to be a great stand-up comic, Rock replied, 10,000 motherfing hours. In Outliers, The Story of Success 2008 by Malcolm Gladwell, many patterns are analyzed as to why some people are more successful when compared to other people. There is little doubt that Malcolm Gladwell is an engaging storyteller, clearly a result of his background as a journalist. That is often easy to see because life rewards those who make great effort in general. It is often the grist of rumor and innuendo as to why or how some people make it to the top of the food chain. Everyone has something to learn from this, either about themselves, those they may seek to help, and those whom they may choose to emulate. His style of writing is friendly and easy to keep up with for the average reader. Swiss, be who you are, and say what you feel, because those who mind don't matter, and those who matter don't mind. Again, observe the slant line from top right to bottom left, and notice the club shapes. They are in three vertical lines, and the remain only have two. Finally, the hearts and diamonds only occur in two vertical lines, not three. Therefore, the option fits the requirements, and is the answer. So with the book you get great biographical stories about the Beatles, and Silicon Valley moguls, and the like. But you also learn things about those stories that put their lives into a context you can understand. You also learn of the extraordinary amount of work they also had to put in. The book is broken up into sections, or parts that allow you to focus on one concept at a time, and truly ingest all of the information being passed. He relates opportunity to timing in a way that acts as a function of time. As an entrepreneur, this book is a fundamental tool in forming the proper mindset to achieve success. There is no way someone can read this book and not get anything out of it. The best part is writing about areas that you may not find in other books. It is important to have this as an author because it demonstrates validity by having multiple proofs of what a person is claiming. Cons can be a bit heavy, but not heavy like a scientific journal article if someone is expecting this to be more lighter reading. Basically, the book looks at different people and cultures, and considers what it takes to be successful. The book, in fact, does quite a bit of research on what makes people successful. Your culture may lend itself to seeing numbers and math in a way others don't. Proper preparation is also required, but these two factors are not enough without the most crucial element, opportunity, the one thing that's almost completely out of our control. As for talent and intelligence, consider this. In 1921, the creator of the Stanford-Binet IQ test, Lewis Terman, sorted through the records of 250,000 elementary and high school students, and selected 1,470 children whose IQ scores were between 140 and 200. 100 is average, Einstein's was 150. He tracked their progress for the rest of his life, and found that the majority ended up with ordinary careers. Before the Beatles became world-famous rock legends, they were given the chance to play in Hamburg, Germany between 1960 and 1962. They played at a club that required them to perform 8 hours a night, 7 days a week. In study after study of composers, basketball players, fiction writers, ice skaters, concert pianists, chess players, master criminals, and what have you, this number comes up again and again. It seems that it takes the brain this long to assimilate all that it needs to know to achieve true mastery. 20% of the people on this list were born in the same country and in the same decade. If these two groups of overachievers had been born a decade earlier, or a decade later, they would have never been in the right place at the right time. It's not the smartest or most talented who succeed, and it's not simply the most prepared. It's people who were given opportunities right at the time that they were most prepared to capitalize on them. In order to really succeed, you only have to be talented, or smart enough, you have to be well prepared, and most crucially, you have to be given the opportunity. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe, and leave your comments below.